Hi everyone, Simona here from Vectortwist. It's time for another type effect tutorial, and in this tutorial today I would like to show you how to create a broken glass effect. As you can see in the background, I'm going to show you how you can break up your text and then turn it into a glass-like effect. But that's not all. The steps I'm going to show you will help you even create other effects here in Illustrator. Let me quickly show you. Once you've broken up your text, you can even give it funky colors, and then use the 3D tools to create a block-like effect. So let's start right away. First, we need some text. So I already prepared the text here. It's Vectortwist. I'm using a really bold font. The font is called Abadi MT Condensed Extra Bold. And once we've written out our text, we want to outline it. So with the text selected, we're going to type and choose Create Outlines. Now our text is a vector shape, and then we can start splitting it up into pieces so we can create our glass effect. Now in Illustrator, you can use different tools to come to the same outcome. And I'm a fan of really finding the easiest way to do things. So in order to cut up our shapes here from our text, I think the best way to go about it is choosing the knife tool. Now the knife tool you can find over here in the toolbar. Here where you can see our eraser tool, just click and hold with the mouse key, and all the way on the bottom you have your knife tool. Now we'll select the knife tool and then we'll start cutting up our text. Now before we use the knife tool, we want to make sure that we select all of our text. So let's select it, then go back to the knife tool, and then we want to cut it into pieces. We want to pay attention that we're cutting in straight lines. And in order to do that with the knife tool, all we have to do is press and hold the Option Alt key on the keyboard, and then we can start dragging across our text, and as you can see, we're cutting in straight lines. So just start and cut it into pieces. Where you want your pieces to be, how long, how small, how tied together, that is really up to you. Now once we've cut everything up, we want to pull the shapes away from each other. First, we have to select our text, go to Object, and then select Ungroup. And then after that, we can select our shape singly, and then either with the cursor or with the arrow keys on the keyboard, you can move them out of the way. How far the gap is in between the shapes, this is really up to you. This step is a little bit tedious, so it takes some time, but this is how you can create the shattered glass effect here on the text. Now I have separated all of the shapes, so let me just show you what the end result will look like. Now here you have the shapes in Illustrator moved apart, and you can already get the idea of the shattered glass effect. Now the next step is to create a background with a blue gradient. So let's select the rectangle tool and create a rectangle on top of the text and then move it to the back. Go to Object, Arrange, Send to Back. And then here in my toolbar, just to show you that we're behind the text, I'm just going to quickly apply a white and black gradient. But I have already created a blue gradient for us. So I'm going to apply it. I'm going to turn on the gradient annotator by pressing G on the keyboard, and then just moving the gradient upwards a little bit and stretching it out. Next, we want to lock our background, so we select it. So we go to Object, Lock, Choose Selection. Now we want to apply a gradient to our shapes here. Now if I select all of them and open up the swatches panel, I'm going to choose the white and black gradient. And as you can see, it applies the white and black gradient to each shape singly. But in order to turn it into a glass-like effect, we want to apply it as if it was one single gradient on top of one single shape. In order to do that, we need to create a compound path. So let me show you. With all of the shapes selected, let's go to Object, Compound Path, and select Make. Now when I apply the gradient, you can see how it applies it to all of the shapes as if all of the shapes were one single shape. Now we need a radial gradient instead of a linear one, and I've already created one for us. So I'm just going to apply it. Press G again on the keyboard to open up the gradient annotator, and then just stretch it out a little bit. Now we're going to open up the transparency panel in the toolbar here, and then we're going to set the blending mode from normal to color dodge. Now the next step is to apply a 3D effect. So we're going to select our shape, we'll go to Effect, 3D, and we'll choose Extrude and Bevel. Now here in the pop-up, we're going to set all of the values of the degrees to 0. We're going to drag it up a little bit to approximately about 6 or 7 degrees. Then we'll turn on the preview and then we press OK. And now you can see that we've created a shattered glass-like effect on our shape here. If you would like to have another idea what you could do, instead of working with the fill, you could just work with the stroke. So here, let me show you. So here I've taken the same text, and instead of using a fill, I've just applied a stroke. It is set to color dodge as well in the transparency settings, but I've used a custom brush. But more on custom brushes and how to use them for glows and strokes in another tutorial. Before we end this tutorial, I would just like to show you what else you could do by breaking up text like this. Instead of creating a shattered glass effect, you could get a little creative and create a broken up stone effect. The breaking up with the knife tool is the same, and instead of using a blue gradient to create a glass effect, I've just colored the pieces in different kind of pastel colors. And then again, I've used the 3D tools, and let me show you when I go here into the appearance panel, and simply applied a different custom rotation to it. And this is it. Now I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, so please give it a like. Subscribe to the channel here in Vectortwist, and at the same time, go to vectortwist.com to the blog to find more tutorials on how to learn Illustrator and get really efficient with it. I'll see you next time.